Well, guys, this is very exciting. Last night, Angie chose Carlin as her happy ever after in the finale of The Bachelorette, and even they said their love story was straight out of a romantic comedy, which sounds like a really great idea to me. In any great rom-com, there's what they call a meet-cute.
Mwah.
And in this one, the attraction was instant.
Hot diggity damn. He is one good-looking sort. That white suit was just like, oh.
We watched their love blossom in iconic scenes like drinks in a paddock, a rub down, and a serenade.
Something brand new.
She's frothing it. You can serenade me.
But no rom-com is complete without another man, or 20 men, competing for the leading lady's heart, and they'll say or do anything.
Completely ungenuine.
Whoa.
He walks around this place peacocking, talking about being the 2020 Bachelor next year.
But despite Jamie's best efforts, Angie and Carlin overcame what had been thrown at them, and it was back to smooch town. But Carlin wasn't prepared for a cameo from his brother playing the villain.
We had a time where one of the guys said that Carlin isn't here for me and that he's here for his acting career and modelling career. And you think that he could be using this for that?
I guess so.
What the shit?
But ultimately, love triumphed all, and this actor landed the role of a lifetime.
There's no doubt in my mind now that I feel like you are the perfect guy for me.
What are you doing to me?
Angie and Carlin the movie, out now in real life.
Roll the credits, I said I would go. Roll the credits, roll the credits.
Fast forward 6 months, we could be living together. I could be pregnant. I'm just kidding, relax.
Would you please welcome the stars of The Bachelorette, Andrew and Carlin?
Hey, y'all.
Everything that every man wants to hear after they've dated somebody for 9 weeks amongst 20 dudes.
Well, I must ask now, are you living together? Any babies on the horizon? What's the deal?
Oh, my God. No.
OK, all right.
That was just extreme Angie excited saying things that pour out of my mouth that... You see his face, he's like, oh, I'm so...
Angie, there are a lot of cameras around right now. Do you feel like you're on a date?
I can't, yes! How many dudes are in the audience? Who have I passed?
17 counted.
Carlin, we have to ask you something.
Yes.
Last night we heard Angie refer to Tim as her soulmate.
Mm.
I just want to know, I didn't think anything topped soulmate, but somehow you've managed to do it. What is your package that you've somehow usurped soulmate?
I know, I think... Angie has explained this really well, that, you know, a soulmate for her, it's, you know, you have soul ties with many people in your life, you know, people who come along your way, special people that, you know, you just have an incredibly special bond with, but that doesn't necessarily mean they own her heart. And, you know, the way that Angie explains is that I was the one who got her heart at the end, and for me, that's so special.
Yeah.
Oh, good answer. Good answer. I'll give you that one. Very well done.
Tim looked very brokenhearted last night, though. Have either of you spoken to him?
We both have.
Yeah.
Tim is one of those people, and I'm one of those people, when I make a connection with somebody, I don't care about contracts. I don't care about what you're not supposed to do. Mm. I want to be there for them and vice versa. I feel after the time we spent together, and he wrote to me about, I think, 2 weeks after, exactly like he said he was, would, in a funny way, very respectable to Carlin. Because as soon as he does, he'll call Carlin and go, how are you? And I'll be like, Tim's called me. He's like, yeah, he's called me too. Like, he's so respectable.
Yeah, he is, he
but,
is.
But, yeah, no, 100%. I'm not going to lie. Tim and I talk. Mm. And as soon as we talk, I tell Carlin, and he's usually already spoken to Carlin before that. It's all just, it's a unique experience. It's weird. Everybody's like, I don't get it, but... You don't get it unless you're in it. Hey,
yeah,
like,
that's right.
And
well,
I'm
is, like, Tim took it really well, and the nation has fallen in love with him. I mean, it kind of makes you want to date him, doesn't it?
Like, I did date him for 9 weeks, and that's why he was in my top two. But oh, no, I know what you mean. He's, you know what? He's a beautiful soul for a very beautiful human. Mm. But
why are you pointing at me, Angie? Fine, I'll date
you. That's what I mean.
All right.
Tell us how you really feel.
Country girl that's fun and funny and just
So you've both fallen in love. You've now gotten to spend some private time together away from the cameras. Have you picked up on any annoying habits of the other in doing so?
So many. No, I'm just kidding.
You probably picked them up on filming. He's like, oh, here we go.
No. No. No, honestly, not annoying habits. I mean, when two worlds collide, it's never going to be picture perfect. And that's the thing, is that wasn't our love story. It wasn't picture perfect.
Nothing about my season was picture perfect. And that's what. But they portray, I feel like, not they, like, Carlin looks like this, like, picture perfect human, but he's not. They didn't show. They didn't show the parts where he's like such a dork and I'm a dork and we'll just like, we'll just dance for hours and we're together and we're just dancing and we're just drinking and we're dancing and we're cooking. Like, that's what I wanted, you know? Somebody that doesn't judge me.
Dancing and cooking. We get
dancing
it.
Yeah, cooking, yeah, sweating, it dancing and cooking.
Yeah, Angie, I get it. Dancing and cooking.
Now, Angie, in the you know, the very important thing, the very first Instagram post after it's announced, you talked about your walls, and in fact, both of your walls that you had to tear down for this relationship to work. Where did the walls come from? Why the walls?
So many walls, Chris. You, out of all people, know. You've watched me in the jungle. I had so many walls even going into the jungle. Mm. I always thought I had to be this like perfect person, but there's nothing perfect about me. I had an interesting upbringing. You know, everybody does. Yeah. Family stuff. You know, you don't want to go into it too much. Everybody's got it. And then all of a sudden one day I was like, I've done all the things I wanted to do as an individual. And in the jungle, I had the discussion with Richard Reed and I was like so ready to fall in love. It wasn't a plan. People were like, oh, it's such a setup. It's like, no, we just chatted and it showed. And yeah.
You had your light on, you were ready. There you go.
And that's it. It happened. Well, and I was ready to roll.
Well, speaking of jungle campmates, your bestie, of course, Evie, what does she make of the whole situation?
She was great at the bachy date. She was... Yeah. Oh, that rhymes.
She'd be a producer.
Oh. Later. She, Carlin and Ryan were her top. From memory. That was a boozy night. We saw dudes naked.
Okay.
But but no, we FaceTimed her last night. She had no idea. Mm. No idea. She would just be like, Ryan, Carlin, Kieran, T and da 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 da. And she was hysterical. She's so happy for me. Because it's like, you don't meet many people like Carlin. You really don't. He's so beautiful.
Oh, thanks, boo.
And they don't get to see what we really had.
Yeah.
And you only see what they want to show, and we're very grateful.
Well, that's very clear. And The Bachelorette and lots of dudes naked will be back in 2020. Would you please thank Angie and Carlin?
Hey, stick around because the awesome Paul Kelly is performing for us live here in the studio.